You're watching the free version of Silhouette Essentials. For projects and footage, head to BorisFX.com for the premium download.
Welcome to this first class, which will be an introduction to Silhouette and getting started with rotoscoping. My name is Katie Morris, and I'll be your instructor. This first class will have two shots that I will work on, so let's get started. I've launched Silhouette, and now I have some options. I'm going to create a new project. I'm going to name my project Class 1 Shot 1 Demo and hit Return. Create project. So now we have an empty application and we need to load in our footage, and there's several ways to do that. One can go to the menu at the top, File, Import Media. One can go down to the Sources window on the lower left. This is where our footage will end up, and click the icon here, which is the import icon, or my favorite way is just to double click in the Sources window. I see my sequence here. I'm going to select it and I'm going to press Open. For this course, we'll be working on JPEGs because the file size is smaller. So you can see here in my Sources window, I have a thumbnail of my footage. There's a couple different ways to view your footage, which is thumbnail, or you can do list view with thumbnails, or just plain list view. So we can just choose the thumbnail option for this class. So now we want to view our footage and start working on it. So to do that, we need to create a session. We can double click on this thumbnail here and it appears in the viewer, but we can't work on it yet until we have a session set up in the trees window to the right. This is where our nodes will be and we will do all our operations there. There are several ways to create a session. First, you want to make sure that you are selected on your footage in the sources window. So make sure we are selected on the source, and that way Silhouette will understand the color space. And one can either click the little icon at the bottom here to create a session. The new session context will come up there, or one can go to File, Session, New Session, or one can just drag the footage into the trees window, and we'll just do that. We'll drag it into the trees window and the dialog box comes up. So it's good practice to name your session. We'll just call this Roto Demo. And then we'll go down to the template option here in this pull down. And we have some choices here of None, Composite, Painter, Roto. We're just going to stay selected on the Roto template because that's what we're doing for this class. And then we get to choose our workspace. It's defaulting to the streamlined workspace, but we have some other options that are worth exploring as well. And you can even make a custom workspace. So we're going to leave the selected on the streamlined workspace. And then our format is already here included. When you create a session and you select it on your footage, it automatically interprets the qualities of your footage. So it has the format, the size, the pixel aspect, duration, the FPS, the start frame, and our bit depth is 8-bit. So you always want to double check these, but most of the time it's already correct, and click OK. So now you can see that our session now appears in the trees window. And right here where it says Roto Demo is our session, and you can have multiple sessions. But right now we're in the Roto Demo session, and you can see that the object list from the Roto node is next to the trees window. It kind of makes a little space in the streamlined workflow where you can have both of these windows in this area in the interface. So let's talk about some of the icons in the trees window. I'm just gonna drag the split line down here on the object list so we can have a little more room. So right here, you can see we have our source, our Roto node, and our output node. We might want to add one or two more nodes to help us with our rotoscoping, but for right now, we're just fine with these three nodes. Here we have an icon that shows us the overview. We want to turn that off. We just click that and it disappears, or click it back on. If we have a node tree that is very large, this is good because you can just navigate around. If something is not visible in the viewer, you can just bring it back. And then these other icons here are sort of self-explanatory. You can clean up your node tree. If you have a lot of nodes in here and things are kind of not organized well, you can just click C and it will organize them. And then we have the extract node if you want to extract a node from the tree, you would just extract it or click E, but we don't really need to do that at this point. And then here is the icon for disabling a node, and you can load in a node that you previously saved and export nodes as well. And I do that a lot. And the last icon here is to add a node with the tab, and we'll do that later. Next, I'll bring up the preferences for the trees window. Go to Silhouette, Preferences, and in the user interface, you have some choices here. You can change the background color, the connection color, which you see I've done already. And you can also select whether you want the connections to be curved or straight. And you have some color options for the group color and the node colors themselves. And I keep my input order and layout to the defaults. You can see here, I have FG and BG, and I have the vertical layout. And we just click OK. So anything here is just a personal preference for how you want things laid out in the trees window.